Welcome to the Late Night Snacking Podcast.
We're your hosts, Devin and Anita, and this is our weekly podcast where we grab a blanket and some snacks and talk about all things relationships, growing pains, and navigating through, honestly, life itself.
We hope our experiences encourage others to grow to become the best versions of themselves, for themselves, and for their relationships. Grab a snack and let's go! What is up, snackers?
Woo! What's going on?
Welcome back to the pod.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you for joining us on the Late Night Snacking Podcast.
The what?
The most honest podcast, the most open podcast, and the most wholesome podcast in the world.
Welcome back to the pod, y'all. I ain't even gonna lie to you.
Aggravated. I'm not gonna lie.
The front we just put on for the first like 20 seconds is immaculate. We
pissed.
We just spent the last, I'd say roughly 50 minutes to an hour.
Equipment, just
everything,
the lights, the camera,
the action, mics, the mics, everything was just wrong. Everything that could go wrong went wrong. So we're here though, and we're here to deliver a pod. Hopefully I'm crossing fingers. If there's anything that I see during editing, like I'll try and fix, but I'm hoping that there's no like blurry zoom in, zoom out action going on. We spent like an hour trying to figure that out. Hopefully we got everything right, but yes, we're going to bring y'all a show like we always do, though, so we're going to truck along. Welcome back. By the time y'all are seeing this, we are actually mid-cruise, so hopefully, speaking to future us, hopefully we're having fun.
Yeah, no, for real.
And, but we just, since we're, like, back in a new season, not new season, we're back during this season. We just want to make sure we're being like consistent with content. So yeah, we just want to make sure we still got an episode out for y'all this week. So like Devin said, thank y'all for joining us.
Yeah. Oh, if you haven't, go and check out the wedding vlog.
Yes.
You probably should have by now. But if you haven't, go do so.
Yes. And hope y'all enjoyed last episode. We were talking about growing in a relationship, growing together versus not waiting on somebody to grow with them, yada, yada, yada. Hope y'all enjoyed. And like I always say, if you have any more, you know, comments or...
Hit us up.
Yeah. Anything
let us know
you
want
to talk about, let us know. So, yeah. What are we snacking on? What are the vibes?
It's some little, I think it's Cajun spicy and sweet.
Yeah.
Trail mix.
It's actually from
Aldi.
From Aldi. Y'all already know. Mm-hmm. Now, we really weren't on the trail mixes like that. And then we just decided we wanted to switch up our snacks a little bit.
Yeah.
So we went digging, literally digging into the boxes in Aldi to see what we could find. And we came across this sweet and spicy Cajun trail mix.
It's really good.
It's got peanuts, butter, toffee peanuts, Cajun-style corn sticks, roasted corn, honey-roasted sesame sticks, and almonds. Very good combination. Yeah, combination
very seasoned
of all the things.
Combination.
So, yeah. So, that's what we're snacking on. What else? What else is new? Nothing, really.
Nothing.
Oh.
And the school year.
Yes. Aww.
Yes. Last day was the 7th.
Now, this is your first year at this school, right?
Yes, my first year.
Okay, give a small...
At middle school.
Give a small synopsis. Like, what? How do you feel about the year? You met some new friends. You seen some new faces in the kiddos.
Yeah. Thoughts? Like, the staff, for the most part, they're cool. Like, I don't think there's anybody there that I don't get along with, you know. Everybody's pretty much, like, chill for the most part. Everybody's pretty much cool. I get along with everybody.
Cool.
There's quite a few teachers around, like, my age, so I you know, click in with them and hang out with them sometimes. Middle schoolers are...
This is your first year with the middle schoolers, right? Unhinged.
Yeah, like...
This is your first year with the middle schoolers?
Yeah.
Okay.
First year. Coaching soccer was cool. Like, that was fun.
Yeah, you did do that.
Which segue... Well, I'm not going to give that out. I'll leave that information to myself. I'll keep that to myself. But, okay. Yeah, the middle schoolers are unhinged. Like,
yeah,
it's crazy. Like, it's nothing compared to the elementary school I was at, literally day and night. But some of the kids are cool. Like, I built some pretty good relationships with a lot of them. Like, they're cool. You know what I mean? Some of them are all right. I would much rather, though, like, deal with sixth graders, though, than, like, the best grade, if I had to go by order, like, it goes, like, sixth, eighth, and seventh.
The seventh graders are that bad?
Yeah, seventh graders are that bad, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, my gosh. Like,
chaotic behavior. Eighth grade is bad, too, but, like, they're not as, because they still, they kind of have, like, a little bit of a maturity, you know what I mean? Like, but sixth grade, some of them, you know, they try to, like, set a standard of being, like, quote-unquote bad or whatever, but you can see it right through them, right? Like,
yeah.
I can tell, like, who's really, like, a wild and unhinged kid and who's not, like, who's putting up a front, so.
Do you think it's just because, like, maybe they feel like they're grown, but, like, they're not really grown? Like, they're in that weird transition period.
Yeah, you're in middle school,
period.
And then,
yeah.
Like, depending on who they know or who rides their bus or who they're hanging out with, they kind of want to be like...
Who rides their bus.
Yeah, like, they kind of want to be like seventh graders or eighth graders.
Oh,
like,
man.
You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
You have that whole thing. But looking forward to year two.
Yay.
At the middle school. I think it'll be interesting.
It'll be interesting.
It'll be very interesting the second go around, so... But honestly, I just took this year to kind of like observe, see like who's who, what's what.
Yeah, get acclimated.
To know the kids and stuff, build some rapport. So year two, we should be good.
That's good. Proud of you. Got through it. Commend you because it's a lot of patience and I could literally never.
And I remember going to school like we went what 180 days. Like, now they go, like, 171 or 177, something like that.
Dang.
In North Carolina, anyway, here. Which is crazy, because I'm like, bro, y'all don't even go to school as long as us anymore. It seemed like we were out of school a lot. Like, every month, like, we were
there
getting some type
something,
of break.
Something, yeah.
Like,
some sort of holiday break.
Crazy. I ain't complaining, though. It's cool. Yeah.
Word. Well, that's cool. Hopefully, we have a nice, fun summer.
Yeah.
Well, you... Us corporate baddies don't get the summers anymore. There is no summer for us. There's
oh no, well,
PTO.
I do need to find like a little hustle though.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I'm only a 10 month employee, not 12 months, so I won't get paid like the days that we're not like over the summer. I don't like so in June. That's it.
You better hit up Carowinds. Did I tell you I used to work at Carowinds?
Yeah. Oh, Marshalls
for
is
like
hard.
A month?
I don't know.
Or I'm Marshalls, slick. Yeah.
So like kind of leading towards that, I might do that. I don't know.
Okay. Shoot. Get some discounts. Hey.
For the 4 weeks that I'll be there.
Hell yeah.
If even that.
I'll take that.
By the time we come back from a cruise and
I know
after the whole like hiring process and stuff, I'll probably literally be working like.
That's the hard part. Teachers.
Like 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Teachers that listen to us, if y'all have any game on like summer gigs. Let us know, because I feel like that's hard to balance. Like, naturally, you take vacations over the summer, and you're supposed to, like, try and work a part-time in between that.
Oh, well, no, well, see, that's just for my position, right? Like, if like
sixth
grade teachers, they're 12 months, so they get paid throughout the summer. Like,
oh, well,
it's some, yeah,
staff that isn't 12 months,
yeah,
give us the game. It'd be good to know.
After school, probably like summer camp programs and stuff like that.
Oh, summer camp. Those were the days. Mm-hmm. Well, cool. I'm excited for you, and we'll see how next year goes for you. Okay. Other than that, I don't think we got anything new coming up. It's weird being in this phase now because I feel like when we were in wedding mode, we were like, and now we have this going on. And now we've talked to this person. And now we're in this part. And now that it's over, it's like, all right.
Regular life starts.
Literally, like, I got work tomorrow. You got work tomorrow. Like, just regular life stuff going on. Yeah. So, but it's cool. Cool. Shall we hop into late tonight slacking?
Yes.
All right, so.
How did I know?
This is what we got going on here. I like to give a little context on the pictures that I choose. Devin just likes to just drop them in here and roast, but I like to give a little background as to why the picture was taken in the first place. This is the face of somebody who knows he's scamming his wife. That's how I'm going to put it. Because the context, if you're...
Scamming my wife is crazy.
If you're a good snacker, you watch the video of
A good snacker. Why is she trying to talk to y'all like she's like a second grade teacher? All right, my little snackers. Tell her don't play with y'all like that. Y'all are wrong.
I don't know where your opinion was seeked out for. But
they understand.
I was
they know
not
what I'm talking
asking
about.
For it. So,
because you're talking to my children.
If y'all watched our vlog, I think it was like we played some games and at the end we did like a little Q&A. We were doing like a, like whoever lost basically had to take a shot. This is the context of the picture because my shot was like this large and I had to take it and this is how he was looking at me.
It was like the little tall shot glasses. Y'all know they have like the little indent at the bottom that makes it look like it's a lot, but it's really not.
Go back and watch the video. I think it's called like Game Night Vlog or something like that. Go back and watch and come back to this video and let me know what kind of shot that was. Scamming me. Scamming. So that's that.
The way you just tried to like depict me to be some type of scammer is crazy.
I don't have to.
They don't believe you anyway. You're not a believable person. But.
Okay, drop in the comments right now. You know what?
They don't believe you.
I need our keyboard warriors to come in the comments and defend me because I know.
Check out the martyr over here. Come and defend me. From what? You only need defending when you're being attacked and nobody's attacking you.
Oh, I am being
reverse. Attacked. Yeah, I like that reverse card, ain't it? Got him.
You didn't get anybody.
Got him.
We're moving into tonight's topic because I'm done with this.
Good. Okay.
I'm usually like, is there anything else you want to say? But we're not even giving you the opportunity. Here we go.
Good job.
Moving on.
Good job.
Can you tell we're in a mood today? Okay, so, dang, did I pick tonight's topic too?
Yeah, you sure did.
Oh my God. Okay, so tonight's topic is adult friendships and everything that goes into them, or every little nuance that we could think of for this. Mm-hmm. And like we always say, if there's things that you feel like we missed or things you want us to touch on or things you want to discuss, hop in the comments.
Yep,
so,
let us know.
Okay, so... Basically, kind of how it came up is because I feel like I'm a very low maintenance friend, but I feel like I'm only this way because I'm older now, I've grown up, I very much live my own life, and then when I get to see my friends, I hang out with my friends, like I'm cool with that. Like I would almost rather like see them periodically, not like all the time, because I'm very like, I don't feel like I need that camaraderie all the time. Whereas I feel Devin is very like social and friend oriented and likes to be around friends and that, like, we've talked about this, like it fuels your social battery type thing. So that's kind of how I was thinking about like, oh, that'd be like a good topic for adult friendships because there's different things that go into it, like as you get older, things change from like childhood friendships. Yep. And as you get into relationships, your friendship dynamics change. Mm-hmm. So I just thought it was an interesting topic to kind of tap into. So there's a few things I wanted to hit on.
Okay. Well, while you're gathering those.
Yeah. I was about to say, you can hop in and share.
Yeah. As much as we hate to see it, as much as we hate to say it, but like when you get into a relationship or when you get married and stuff, like, I'm not going to say like you lose touch with your friends, but I guess the atmosphere and the environment definitely does shift.
Yeah.
Because especially if you're, you know, in a group of single friends and you're the only one married, like, of course,
yeah,
your time is going to be going to be a little different from everybody else's.
Yeah.
Slightly, but I mean, it doesn't mean that the friendship's over, though.
No. Right?
Like, you just kind of have to, like, accommodate, you know. So it's like, you know, if I'm out, you know, with the boys or whatever, you know what I mean? We're not going to go to a strip club. Like, oh, let's go to a strip club. We're not going to do that. Like, come on. Like,
yeah.
That is not an environment for for me. So
I also just think it's like interests are different between friends who are in a relationship and friends who are not. Like,
yeah,
there's certain boundaries. I don't want to say restrictions, but there's just like boundaries and lines that you don't cross when you're in a relationship with somebody, whereas your single friend does not have any boundaries of anything. Right. Not that they're just out here wilding, but like they don't have somebody else to think about when they're making decisions.
Right. They can be selfish.
For a night out. Yes.
And exactly. Which is fine. It's really okay to be selfish in that type of situation. Like, you don't have to answer anybody. You literally bite. Like, it's just you. You know what I mean? You're responsible for yourself. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but like that dynamic is hard sometimes. Like when you are the friend that's in a relationship because you're out at whatever time thinking about your partner, and you're like, I should probably go home, or we probably shouldn't be here. Like, my partner probably wouldn't like this. Like, there's so many things that like you are thinking about that like your single friend is not. Oops, sorry, y'all. Not thinking about whatsoever because they don't have to. Like, that's just not the place in their life that they're in. But just like Devin said, like, it doesn't mean that your friendship with this person is like over. It's just there's certain things, I guess, that you can do with your single friends and some things that just like don't really fit with your single friend joining along. And that was one of the things that I wanted to touch on was like, how do I explain it? Like, there's certain friends for certain things. Like sometimes you have like your turn up friends. Sometimes you have like your couple friends that you do like couples trips with and stuff like that. Sometimes you have your friend that like, you know, you're going to do, I don't know, do some business with. Like, sometimes these are not all the same friends. Like, you don't, like, just because, like, you're best friends with somebody doesn't mean that person is the friend to do everything with. Like, some friends can help you in some other areas, and sometimes you have interests with other friends that, like, maybe your quote-unquote best friend doesn't have that interest with you. Like, to me, like, there's certain friends for certain things, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. So, like, sometimes your single friend maybe could be a friend to go have a night out with, but, like, your single friend probably wouldn't tag along with you on, like, a group couples trip. Do you see what I'm saying? Like, it's just different environments for different types of friends.
Right. I don't know, I agree.
Oh, I thought you were going to chime in and say something. I was like, you have the floor. But, yeah, another one that I wanted to touch on was like growing up, like how friendships and stuff are really convenient because these are people that you're going to school with and you see them every day. And it's kind of like not by choice because you have to go to school. So like by default, you make bonds with these people because like you literally see them for the majority of your day. And if you're really close with them, you're probably seeing them after school too. So you're spending so much time with these people. So the convenience of having friends at like a school child age is just so much easier than it is in your adult life. When you're living your adult life, you most likely have a job and you have responsibilities. And now things like money come into play. Things like, oh, I have kids come into play. Things like, oh, I have work that I cannot take off to come see you come into play. Friends move to different states, so now it's a flight that costs money to get to these people.
And that's a lot, too.
It is a lot. And, like, calendars, like, I see jokes all the time where, like, it's like, oh, when are we going to hang out? Everybody busts out their calendar. Oh, does March of 2025 sound good? Like, that's literally what it is, like, in adulthood, like, trying to hang out with friends. And, like, it's just, I don't know, it's crazy to me, like, the difference between the two. But I don't know. Do you feel like that makes it harder to manage adult friendships because there are so many more factors now than there were when we were kids? It just seems like it was a lot simpler when we were kids, you know?
And honestly, like, I think it all depends on the bond, too. Like, if this is, like, your best friend or this is somebody that you grew up with, then I think that, honestly, it's easy because it's just a communication thing, right? Like, oh, like, what do you got going on this summer? Oh, nothing. Like, you know what I mean? So it's easy to set that up if there's equal grounds of communication, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Like, but if this is somebody that, you know, you probably talk to probably about 10 times throughout the year. You know what I mean? Like, not very often, but just kind of they pop in and pop out. Like, yeah, it's probably going to be a little bit harder to set something up with that person.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah, marriage does play its part in that, especially if you have kids and you have a wife or a husband or whatever. Like, yeah, those are some factors that you do have to consider, but I feel like anything can be fixed or, you know. If you really want to see somebody, like, you'll go do it. And if that person wants to be seen by you, they'll make time. They'll make time available for that.
Yeah. I think that's what it comes down to, is just like the effort piece, right? Like,
yeah. But I do get your point though, where it's like your friends or whatever, you used to see them in school every day. Like,
yeah.
It's everybody was easily accessible.
100%.
The only thing that changes is, like, your accessibility because you get older and, you know, you move, you get different jobs, you
have families and stuff.
Yeah, so
yeah,
that's all that is.
Yeah. I think the effort piece is really important because, like I said, in the school day and age, like, how much effort did you really have to put in hanging out with your friends? 9 times out of 10... because you all went to the same school, you probably lived relatively close to each other because you're zoned in the same school.
Yeah.
So, like, how far did you really have to travel to see your best friend? What time did you really have to make? Anybody can just pop on FaceTime. FaceTime was a thing when we were in high school. Like, anybody can, like, just pick up the phone, call your friend, walk over to their house if they're close. Like, it was just that easy, whereas, like, now it's not. So, like, what effort did you really have to put in when you were younger? Like, not a ton. Right,
middle
right?
school, me and the homies used to walk to my house.
That's what I'm saying.
My house is like pretty much the hangout spot after school for like a little while.
And we just don't have that, like, ease.
We play ball.
Yeah, we don't have that ease of access anymore. So, like, that effort piece is so important. And I see why, like, friends, you know, grow apart and things like that. Like, I can personally say that, like, I've grown apart from some of my friends that I used to go to school with in, like, Jersey and Texas and stuff like that, because just naturally, like, I'm far away from these people. When I moved to a new school and made new friends, like, point blank effort on both sides, like, dwindled. Like, it's not that easy to keep far long distance friendships and stuff like that if you're not putting in the effort. So, like,
even with family too.
Yeah, like,
it's the same with family.
Family that you haven't seen in a long time and stuff like that, like, all of that is effort. Like, 9 times out of 10, if you haven't seen an aunt or something in like 5 to 7 years, it's probably because you haven't really called her. You haven't.
Yeah.
Neither of you have bought a plane ticket to see each other. Like, that's, it's just point blank, like, the effort just wasn't there. So I'm finding with like adult friendships, like there's so much more effort that has to go in it. But like if these people are really your friends, like you'll make it work. Like this past weekend, so y'all can probably get an idea of when we're recording this by me just saying that. But me and Cicely just went down to Atlanta to see Tia. And that is a perfect example of like being an adult and making an effort to see your friend, even if it's only for 24 hours. Like we both live 4 hours away from Georgia. So we probably spent almost as much time driving back and forth from Georgia up here than we spent in Georgia. So like, but that doesn't matter because like we love Tia and we want to see her and we want to support her and stuff like that. But it's just like sometimes it does take 8 hours of traveling back and forth to go see your friend. And like not everybody wants to put in that time. Not everybody wants to, maybe some people don't even have the means to do that. But like if you have the means, if you have the time and you make that time, like go do that. Like if friendships are important to you, like you're going to find ways to like make it known to your friend that like they are important to you in their life, et cetera, et cetera.
So, and real quick, I do want to talk. I do want to touch on the pressure of feeling like you have to make these things happen. It's okay to say no.
Yeah.
It's okay to miss out on a trip or a group trip or whatever because there just may be bigger fish to fry somewhere else. You know, like rather might need to save up because of, you know, maybe trying to pay off some bills or something or, you know, you got something important coming up. So probably just need to chill to prepare for that. You know, like it's okay to say no. Like, because I know sometimes like we get caught in this thing and we're like, oh, I just got to be there for my boy. Like, or I got to be there for the girl. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm going to do whatever it takes. Like, and that's fine. Like, I'm not saying don't be that friend, but I'm saying like, don't feel like you're obligated to do that. I will say that. Like, I know my situation is different just because like the bond that I have with my friend is, I've said it once before, I'll say it again, it's very cult-like. Like, it's just not normal.
Literally.
But it's really, like, it's...
not normal.
It's not, like... No, like, when I say that... Normal, like, yeah, like, because we're all boys and stuff. But just, like, that connection and that bond, like, I don't think there's anything in this world that we're not willing to do for each other.
Yeah.
Like,
Now,
some more than others. Some...
Sure.
Some of them maybe kind of questionable. But, like, all in all, like, I love him anyway. You know what I mean? Like, so.
Yeah. I like that, though, because technically, no, you're not obligated to do anything, really, in any relationship. In a romantic relationship, in a platonic relationship, in a child-to-parent relationship. Nobody is obligated to do anything. But we've talked about this before on an episode where we said just that like, no, you're not obligated to do anything, but that's what makes the effort sweeter and more appreciative. Like, me and Cicely by no means were obligated to go to Tia's event at all, but that's what made it sweeter is that we did make the effort and we showed up. But like, what I'm saying is if you have the means and you have the time, like, I just, like, I would do that for a friend. But that's just me. So I know everybody's not the same and no, you're not obligated, but it just does make the gesture, like, more appreciative when you actually something and you do show up for your friend and you do, you know, put in effort. So, I get what you're saying. Another thing, too, is, like, well, I guess I want to stay on that real quick because there are...
What's about the pressure of feeling you're obligated to go?
Yes, because there are friends who truly, like, just do not have the means, and those friends should not be put on the outs just because they can't make like a trip happen, because I know that's like a thing. That's a thing in our day and age, is that we love to take trips together. Like, if that's the easiest way to get a large group of friends together, where it's like, if I only see y'all once a year, then we're going to do a damn trip together. Like, that is like the thing. We can't just meet up at each other's house. We got to do a trip. So, and I know sometimes like just some friends either cannot swing the bill, either cannot swing the time, maybe can't get a babysitter for kiddos, like whatever situations your friends are in. Like, if they can't come for whatever their means are, I guess like for those types of friends, what are some ways that are like what are some ways they can still show up as a friend without having to bend over backwards for time off of work, for money, for, you know what I mean? Like, because to me, time off of work and money doesn't equate a good friend. Like, there are other ways you can show up and be a good friend. Well, I'm asking this, but I guess it's tailored to how your friend wants to receive love.
Right.
I guess.
Yeah. And I think, like, their prime example, my mom's, like, back in March, it was my mom's birthday, and I wasn't able to make it home.
Yeah.
And so I text Thomas. No, like, I just text him and just asked him, like, hey, bro, like, I can't make it home. It's my mom's birthday, bro. Like, I think it'll make her happy, bro. Just, can you take, like, go take her some flowers for me? No questions asked. Dude, he went to the store, went, got the flowers, took them to my mom. Like, it's stuff like that. Like, it's just that simple. Like, he didn't ask how much the flowers were.
What kind
of flowers did she's like? I gave him an instruction. He followed through, and he didn't have to do that.
Yeah.
He literally could have just told me, like, no, bro, that's your mom. You do it. Like, he could have told me something like that. Yeah. But the fact that I couldn't make it home that weekend, and he would, you know, he went and done, like, done that for me.
Yeah.
Like, I owe him whatever favor he needs. Literally.
Yeah. That's a good example. Because that's not like a plane ticket or a trip or half of an Airbnb or whatever. It's just you needed a quick favor. He was able to come through and good to go. Like, and sometimes, like, sometimes it doesn't even have to be a favor. Sometimes it's just like a phone call when you least expect it from a friend. Like, it could just be anything. Like, I know one of my friends, she wrote me like a little, it was around the time we got engaged, like, I knew she wasn't going to be able to make it to the wedding, but she still sent a card literally saying, like, congratulations, so happy for y'all, like, excited for this new chapter, like, a nice, like, literally, no money, no nothing, just, like, a handwritten, like, she went to the store, she bought a card, she wrote on it a whole little note, and took the time to take it to the post office and send it to me, like,
because it was thoughtful, it's the thought
it that was, counts. Like, literally. Yes, like, and, like, it's just small things like that. But, like, but that's what I was saying before. Like, every friend is different. Every friend receives love different. Like, I love handwritten things. She knows that. Like, she likes to send me postcards here and there and, like, stickers and stuff like that. Like, I like little shit like that. But, like, she knows that. So, it's like, do you know your friend? Do you know other ways you could show up for them if you can't swing something like a trip or a plane ticket or whatever? But if you can, like, this is what I keep saying, like, if you do have the time and the means, like, definitely go see your friends in person and fellowship with them, like, in person. I always encourage that. Even if it's a 4-hour drive, 8-hour drive, 30-minute drive, like, go see your friends. Like, I love when your friends stop by and, like, come say hi to us or whatever. Like, when D came over the other night, stood for a few hours and just hung out with us. Like, that is just simple friendship. Like, you thought about us while you were in the city. You came and swung by and came and hung out.
Yeah. And no, I appreciate that.
No money was spent to hang out with us. Like, literally. Like, so.
Just let me view you, man. Just let me lay eyes on you. Make sure you're all right. I can see for myself that you're healthy. You're taking care of yourself. So.
Yeah.
So, enough for me.
Yeah. So, that's another thing. I did want to talk about outgrowing friendships, because I know that is a big thing, especially when you're kind of like growing up and figuring out life, and you're trying to figure out what path you want to be on. And sometimes you just realize that your friends just maybe are not on that same path, wavelength, headspace that you are in. Doesn't make them a bad person. Doesn't make you a bad person for kind of staying in your lane and moving forward. But like, sometimes when you're like, when you're just doing your own thing, you realize that you are outgrowing some of these people in your life, that maybe what they do in their life and how they live their life just really doesn't fit how you now live your life and what you do. I know a good example of this is I was listening to a podcast, and he was just talking about how he was like getting sober and stuff like that. And he was saying that that was like one of the first things that he realized had to happen, was like separating himself from like his friends that did like to party, drink, like do all of that. And it kind of was just like outgrowing them a little bit and removing himself from that type of lifestyle, because he just like that lifestyle didn't serve him anymore. And he was like, I love them from afar, like there's nothing wrong with them, it's just what they do and how they live their life just doesn't match.
It doesn't align.
It doesn't align, exactly. And so it doesn't always have to be that extreme, and sometimes it is, but sometimes I don't know, sometimes it's just like you think about like you want to move forward and you want to live your life and you want to start a family and maybe you want to start a business and you're doing all these things, and some friends just unfortunately get left behind in that, because they are just not on that type of time. Maybe you don't really want to go out and party anymore. Maybe that's not how you spend your free time anymore. And maybe some friends still, that is their like every Thursday, Friday, Saturday night thing that they're doing. And you just kind of find that you're naturally like growing apart from them, because that's like maybe not what you really do anymore. So I don't know. Have you, not that I'm not asking, have you experienced this, but I'm saying like, do you see why that happens, or like, have you seen that happen, or?
Yeah. I mean, even some would say that it's happening in my friend group, honestly, but I don't look at it that way, because like, there's the space and the age gap between like me and my friends isn't like huge, but there's literally someone in the group that you compare with to live out that type of lifestyle. That's what you want. Like, if that makes sense, you know what I mean? Like, some would say that this happened in my circle where we're outgrowing each other, because some of us don't go out anymore. We don't go clubbing. We don't do this. We don't do that. Like, and it's not that I don't see it that way. It's just we just moved to a different chapter than everybody else. It's still the same book, but just a different chapter, you know?
Yeah.
And hopefully soon, like, those boys are, you know, kind of, it won't be long before they get married and stuff. And then they'll finally see, like, what it's like on this side. Because for a long time, it was mainly just kind of like me and Ramon's, you know? Just kind of like front running a little bit. And then, you know, now that we're married and the jerseys is retired, like, we hung up. So now, like, we're on a whole different ship now.
Yeah.
But it's like we passed the torch down to Tomas. Yeah. Thomas, and we talked to him, like, bro, like, on the back trip, that's what I told him. I was like, if you're mad for you can see it in the thing, I told him, I was like, you're the captain now, bro. Like, you got to lead the way.
I feel like that's natural.
But outgrowing each other, I don't think we've done that. Like, I still enjoy hanging out with them and stuff.
Yeah.
It just might not be in, like, a club setting. But still, like, I'll go grab dinner with them and stuff, or grab a drink or something. Like,
just under, like, different circumstances, most likely. Yeah.
And, of course, like, well, you know, like, we still go out to like bars and lounges and clubs and stuff every once in a while. Very rare that I go to these places by myself, but usually she's with me, which, you know, it just makes sense.
Oh, I thought you were going to say, like, it's not fun. I was like, damn.
Why would I say that?
I don't know. It was... It just seemed that was
like... Who do you take me for?
That was like the direction you were going in. I was waiting for it. Yeah. I was like... Mm.
Yeah, usually when I go with her. But it's not fun, though. Like, what? I just would have never brought that up at all. Versus just saying something mean.
Just got my gloves up today. It's the caramel.
What is this?
It was the caramel functioning. I'm really on edge. But, oh, am I seeing that right? Ooh, we are running out of time, folks. Our camera is going to die.
Yikes.
That is crazy. Oh, there's so much more I wanted to say on this topic, but I don't want to cut it off.
Yeah.
And y'all not have video. So, okay, I'm sorry. This is a short one.
Yeah, unfortunately, this was...
I was going to ask, do you want to try and squeeze in the hookup, or should we just go ahead and close it down before it dies?
I'll make it quick. I'll hook him up with Fico.
Okay, let's hop into... Oh, dang. Okay, we're closing out the topic. Sorry.
Sorry, y'all boys.
Sorry. Hey,
get on to the OnlyFans and the Patreon to get the full version.
Oh, my God. We're hopping into the hookup. Goodbye. I got the hookup, holla if you hear me. I got the hookup, holla if you hear me. I got the hookup, holla if you hear me.
What's going on, Snackers? And I'll be hooking you up. I want to put y'all in this Italian restaurant. I've really been into Italian food lately, like maybe like the past few months.
Yeah.
And I'm determined to try them all out here as much as I can anyway. But this place we tried, this is our second time going here. It's in Noda, the North Davidson side. It's called Figo 36. You can follow them on Instagram at Figo 36 underscore Noda.
I knew it was happening. Sorry. Go ahead and repeat it for them.
Yeah, sorry. The camera just totally died. But you can follow them on Instagram at Figo, F-I-G-O 36 underscore Noda. Yeah, really good Italian restaurant with really good cocktails and drinks as well.
Yes.
Like that, I will honestly give this place, and I've had it twice, I'll give it a 10 out of 10. I'm not even gonna lie.
It's like, great. It's really good. And it's got like a swanky kind of vibe, so it's really good for
The ambiance is...
Yeah, it's really good if you want to go for like a cute little date night type thing. Like, it's the perfect vibe for
really
that.
Nice. I think they have different types of olive oils.
Yeah.
That you can try. Like, yeah, it's a... It's a really nice place.
Yeah.
Again, that is Figo 36. It's in Noda, Charlotte, North Carolina. You can follow them on Instagram at Figo, F-I-G-O 36 underscore Noda.
Cool.
Yeah. Shout out to Figo.
Shout out to Figo. All right. Let's close it down. All right, y'all. I'm so sad because... There was so much effort put into getting the episode up, and then I loved this topic, and we really got into it, and I really felt like we were like right. I could have given another like 15 minutes on this topic, and we sadly were cut short. So sorry about that, y'all. Like we always say, if there are more things you wanted to add or things that we couldn't touch on, feel free to holla at us in the comments. We, of course, would love to hear from you. So. Like all good things, you know, we must come to an end. We got to close out. Anything you want to add or say to the Snackers?
Take care of yourselves.
Yes.
Love your friends. Love yourselves.
Yes.
Go see your friends. Make time for your friends.
Yes.
Spend time with your friends. You know, all that good stuff.
Yes.
You know, 'cause you can't be a good friend if you don't spend time with them. Just saying.
Yeah. Call them. Oops. Call them, speak to them, make some effort. If you're a low maintenance friend like me, you know that doesn't mean every day. You don't have to talk to your best friend every day to be best friends. It's okay. Like, but make time to see each other here and there. Make time to talk to each other here and there. We are beings that are meant to be around other beings and have some sort of community. So find that in your friends and love on them. So, okay. that is all I have on that. Thank y'all for joining us on the Late Night Snacking Podcast, per usual. If you are on the YouTube, unfortunately, you cannot see us right now, but make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Tell your friends to subscribe. Our little subscriber numbers have been going up, so y'all are doing the damn thing and sharing the podcast, and we appreciate that. So continue to do that. If you are listening, you know, our audio warriors, we love you too. If you are on Spotify, make sure you click the follow button so our episodes can pop up. And if you are on Apple Podcasts, click the plus button in the top right to make sure our episodes are there in your little catalog. Yeah. Alrighty. Thank y'all for joining us as always. We love y'all and we will see y'all next Wednesday.